Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name's Jim Beckler. I want to take a few minutes to show you a really nice motorhome. This is a Sunseeker by Forest River. The floor plan is called the 2400B. It's a relatively new floor plan, so got some changes that that they haven't had available up until this point. This is the first one of these that we've actually gotten in. Got some floor plans similar. They've been building motorhomes on this chassis for a long time, but this is a little different in some respects. It also has the new Mercedes chassis, so this is the 19 and a half chassis, so it's got some really a lot of upgrades on some of the safety features that are available, and it's a 2021 model too. Now you may have some questions somewhere along the line. I'll probably miss something that you want to know about. Feel free to give me a call. You can reach me at 541-510-1017 is my direct line. As I mentioned, Forest River is the manufacturer. Great company, been as part of Berkshire Hathaway, so they've got good financial backing. We like that, and that's, I think that's important to note. If you're looking to buy a motorhome, it's good to know that they're built by a manufacturer that has some solid financial footing. That's built on that Mercedes chassis. Like I mentioned, it's got a six-cylinder turbo diesel, 3 liters. It's got plenty of power, good performance, fuel efficient as well. That's one of the things people really like about this chassis, that and the safety features. Full body paint, you're going to like that. Not only does it look nice now, but over the course of time, it's going to hold up better than the non-painted ones that have decals. Typically, they're going to, you know, fade and peel if they're out and in the sun much. So unless you're able to keep it indoors when you're not using it, you know, it's going to have show some wear and tear, whereas this won't. Much better application. I really like the awning, the way they've got it set up on here. It's a nice big patio awning, almost the whole side of the coach. Covers the door, all the area back in here, which usually this is where you're going to be hanging out, spending your time. And that has a light in it also, LED light strip. Do have an outside TV. Looks like we got to clean that up a little bit. Of course, it's going to get a good full detail before you take it home. But the storage down here, we've got a nice storage compartment. We just got this unit in. This one is equipped with a plug-in for portable solar panels. So if you're a dry camper and you wanted to have some solar while you're out there, keep your batteries trickle charged, you can get one of those portable units, just plug it in here, get it outside here, and keep your batteries charged up. So we kind of work our way around the back. See the beautiful colors. The roof on this is a fiberglass roof, so it has a one-piece fiberglass roof, which is a much more durable than like a membrane roof, either a vinyl or a rubber roof. This is going to hold up better, less maintenance overall. Got a ladder to get up there in case you need to get up and do any cleaning or servicing. It is equipped already with tow package. Quick connect back here for propane. Maybe you want to plug in your propane barbecue, which you can do that right there. Here's a little sprayer, so if you want to spray down maybe the pets if they're out there in the mud before they get inside, or maybe the kids are all muddy or got sand on their feet, then all your hookups are right in here. This is pretty much where this is kind of the business side of your trailer. It's your power cord, TV, your fresh water connection, and then this is your black tank flush right here. Allows you to put pressured water to your black tank, help keep that all cleaned out. Outside shower here also, you got hot and cold water you can use for the shower, or again, just spraying things down. Probably not going to be out here taking your daily showers, but just another way to get water. 3600 LP generator. So you got a nice propane power generator. A little storage in here. It's got your short power cord right here, but the one that plugs in right over there. Lots of little storage compartments all the way around down here. Got one of your bigger compartments, and then a little smaller one up here. kind of goes back in there a ways. Another smaller one here. So lots of places to put your stuff. And then right down here is your propane. That's where your propane tank's going to be, or your access for that. It does have side view cameras as well as a backup monitor. So it helps a lot when you're going down the road. You can kind of see what's going on all the way around your coach. Nice, really good looking paint on this one. Not too dark. Let's take a look inside. Again, feel free to give me a call at 541-510-1017 in case you have questions. Let's take a look in here. Again, really nice decor in this one. Start, take a look here in the cab. Now this is, as I mentioned, on the new Mercedes chassis, so it has the upgrades that are new this in this particular chassis. So pretty much have to find a 2020 or a 21 to be able to get this chassis. It's that new. They've been building Mercedes chassis for motorhomes for a long time. In fact, some of the manufacturers started as far back as 2006, but this is a pretty advanced chassis. So what they've done is they've given us electric seats. This has power seats now, whereas before they didn't have that. It does have memory on your seats, has heated seats. There's these front seats are going to spin around, as well as, like I mentioned, their power is, and then you have an integrated steering wheel, so you have controls on there to be able to access your sound system, the cruise control. All that's really easy to get a hold of. And the screen now for your backup camera and the radio, stereo, GPS, all that is a bigger screen, so they've enhanced that as well. So lots of nice features, you know, things, a lot of safety features that we could maybe get in a little bit more detail down the road if you have some more questions about this. But things like integrated cruise control, lane assist, things of that nature that you would expect to see from the Mercedes. It's all in this chassis now this year. TV up on top. You do have that swivels, backs out of the way. You have another bed up here if you need it. Another sleeper. Notice you got lighting up there as well. Nice size slide out. It covers almost this whole side of the motorhome. So your wraparound dinette's included in that. Nice big dinette booth. You've got full extension drawers down in here with nice metal glides. They snap in there pretty hard, so they're not sliding out when you don't want them to. Looks like it's got a little water filters also for filtered water. Got some storage up above here also. Cup holders and lighting back in here too, so really nice. And some plug-ins so you can maybe charge your phone. One of the things that's a little different about this model is it's got a closet in the back. So on up here you've got, well, I guess this would be considered more of a pantry area, and your closet's in the back right across from the kitchen area here, which does house your controls up here for slide out controls are here. You've got access to turn on your hot water heater, water pump. I can turn my generator on right here. Also check all my tank levels. I can see where I'm at with my, you know, black tank, fresh water, that, all of that. This is a nice feature too that you'll like, that especially if you're kind of like to go year round. The Arctic Pack is going to allow you to put direct heat to your holding tanks, keep things from freezing up if you do get caught in some cold weather. A little storage in here, but this is all set up for your entertainment. As a AM FM radio, does come with a CD player also, DVD. One piece, nice deep stainless steel sink. Nice sprayer there. Got little drawers. has come with a convection microwave oven and a two burner stovetop, propane stovetop. And the refrigerator is 10 cubic feet, actually, so it's a pretty good size refrigerator. Now, what's nice about this too is it operates off of your 12 volt. So again, if you're a dry camper, that could be a huge advantage. You don't have to use propane to keep your refrigerator going. It's a pretty good size too, separate freezer and refrigerator there. Bathroom has a stand-up shower in there. So you've got your toilet, sink, and shower all in one area. Should consider more like we call a private bath, so you don't have a split bath. Lighting and everything's right in here. You do have heating and air conditioning in here also. So the bed is a part of the slide out here also, so this adds to that livability of this floor plan. As I mentioned, it's got a nice big slide out, even has a little shelf back there, queen size bed that you can walk around. Has windows in the back, and here's where most of your storage is going to be for your closet items. Got some miscellaneous stuff in there. You got a place where you can hang up there. These are for the front seats. When you spin those front seats around, you can sit up a little bit higher. We've got a table that fits in that area up in the front there too. When you spin those seats around, you can use that to maybe have your coffee or your favorite beverage. So again, more storage makes you just a little bit more livable. This is part of that new floor plan. This is something that they haven't offered prior to this, a similar floor plan in other models, but not exactly like this. So other things to talk about, so feel free to give me a call, 541-510-1017. Just ask for Jim. Thanks.